This video is about how to make the most out of the user interface of puzzle-loop.com. Part 1. General Overview. The playing field consists of three main areas. The control buttons. From here you can control the zoom of the puzzle, the game settings, and you can undo or redo moves. The game timer is also located in this area. The action buttons. From here you can submit the puzzle solution for verification. Reset the puzzle. Print a copy. Share your progress. Or load a new puzzle. The puzzle area. This is the actual playing field where you will enjoy solving puzzles. Part 2. Control buttons. Adjusting the size of the puzzle is an important aspect of the game. Finding the perfect zoom level will help you focus easier. You can use the zoom button to show and hide the zoom slider. Sliding it to the right will enlarge the puzzle, sliding it to the left will make it smaller. You can reset the zoom level to its default position by clicking the 100% button. If you happen to zoom in too much or the puzzle is too big, a scroll bar will appear on the bottom. The second button shows and hides the settings. I'll tell you everything about the settings in part 5. In this area you can also see the puzzle timer. You can compete with other players or with yourself if you are that type of a player. When you start playing a puzzle, your progress is automatically saved on your device. This is in case you accidentally close the browser, the power goes off, or you navigate away. Quite useful for larger daily, weekly, and monthly puzzles as well. Have in mind that the timer keeps running, so you may see ridiculous numbers if you come back after a day or two. If this bothers you, you can simply start a new puzzle or hide the timer altogether from the settings. If you make a mistake or take a wrong path, then the undo and redo buttons are here to help. You can also use the standard keyboard shortcuts, Ctrl plus Z and Ctrl plus Y. Have in mind that if you reload the page or submit your solution for verification, you will lose the ability to undo your moves. Part 3. Action buttons. Once you are ready with solving the puzzle, you can press the Done button to verify your solution. You can also press the Enter key on your keyboard to submit it. If you got it right, then the timer will stop and you will be offered a chance to submit your score to the Hall of Fame. If you messed it up completely, you can press the Start Over button, which will clear all the moves, letting you start from scratch. If you are more of a pen and paper type of a player, you can print the current puzzle using the Print button. This will show you a printer-friendly preview. If you want to print a bigger puzzle and it doesn't fit the sheet, you can zoom it out until it does. You can also use the Ctrl plus P keyboard shortcut. If you want to print more than one puzzle, you can check out the Mass Print section, where you can print multiple puzzles on the same page. If you are stuck, but you know someone who can help you, then you can use the Ask a Friend button. It will show you options to share your current progress to Facebook or Twitter. You will also be able to use the permalink to send your progress to someone in an email, instant messenger, or any other way. If you want, you can also use the link to the screenshot of your current state. If you want to load a new challenge, you can use the New Puzzle button. Part 4. Puzzle area. Enough with the boring stuff. This is the fun area where you will actually solve the puzzles. I will show you how to play with the default settings. The standard method is to play with a mouse. I will show you how to play with the keyboard in part 6 and on a mobile device in part 7. You can click with your left mouse button to place a line. You can also click and move your mouse to place multiple lines. You can click with your right mouse button to place an X. Click and drag to place more than one X. If you hold your Control key while clicking, you will get the opposite effect. Control plus left click places an X. Part 5. Settings. Let's see what goodies do we have here. At the top of the settings section, you can see a toolbar with some very important settings. They are so important for some players that you can pin them on the screen with this Pin Toolbar checkbox. Which I'll do while explaining what they are for. The first four define what happens when you click with your left mouse button. By default, as you can see, we place a black line. If you choose the first button, then the state will rotate from white to black, to X, and back to white. Some players just prefer it this way, but this is particularly useful if you are on a mobile device, where you don't have a right mouse button or a control key to help you place an X. This setting obviously places an X on your left button click. And this one will remove a mark, if you want to erase some area, for example. The final button will let you color the cells in two different ways. This is used to color the inner and the outer side of the loop, if you use this technique. Clicking a cell once will color the cell in one way. Click it again to color it in another way. A third click will remove the color. Although useful, this makes the playing field a bit busy. You can hide these marks by clicking on the button again. And, of course, you can click it again to show them back. Now let's see what other settings we have. The second setting is hide the timer. Some players are not competitive and the timer just makes them feel uncomfortable. Hide it so you can relax while solving the puzzle. The next setting is night mode. If you are playing in the dark and the black on white is too bright for you, this setting will change the colors to relieve your eyes. A good night's sleep is always recommended though. Highlight last change will show a blue outline on the cells you have changed in your last move. Magnify part of the puzzle while drawing. If you play on a touchscreen, and your finger blocks your view, you can enable this setting to see the current part of the puzzle in a separate small window. If you play with your left hand, check this setting and the small window will appear to the right. Highlight line. This setting will change the color of the active line. This is very useful on bigger puzzles when you want to track a longer line to avoid closing a loop. If the setting is switched off, you can still use the shift key and mouse over to highlight a line. When the setting is enabled, the line is activated on mouse over for desktop computers. On touchscreen devices, your last move defines the active line. Auto cross the sides of completed numbers. This setting removes the tedious work of placing X's when a number is completed. Gray out completed numbers. When switched on, all completed numbers will be shown in a gray color. Highlight wrong numbers. If a number is surrounded by more lines than it requires, or there are not enough sides to complete it, this setting will make it red. Highlight wrong moves. This setting will make lines red if there is a crossing or a branch. Draw continuous line. When this setting is off, which is by default, and you drag your mouse to mark more than one line, any line will become black when the mouse moves over it. When this setting is on, your moves will be restricted only to ones which create a continuous line. Dot style. Some players find the dots too big. You can reduce their size by choosing small dot style. Or even more, by choosing the tiny dot style. Part 6. Playing with your keyboard. If you are not a mouse person, or the constant clicking annoys you, or your coworkers, you can use your keyboard to play. First, click inside the puzzle just to make sure it has the focus. Then you can navigate through the puzzle using your arrow keys. You should see a blue outline on the dot that is currently focused. Press the control key and move with the arrow keys to draw lines. Press the shift key and move with the arrow keys to place X's. Use Ctrl plus Z to undo a move, and Ctrl plus Y to redo it. Part 7. Playing on a mobile device. I am going to load the site on iPhone SE, which has a pretty small screen. Obviously, the bigger the screen, the better. Let's see how to adjust the zoom of the puzzle. On mobile devices, you have two options for zooming. First, you have the zoom button and the slider. And second, you can pinch with two fingers to zoom in and out the entire page. If the puzzle is too large for the screen, you can scroll it left and right to reach any part of the puzzle. Another approach is to zoom out the puzzle until it fits the screen. Then you can zoom in the entire page until the puzzle is big enough. This approach also allows you to scroll diagonally. The rotate option is selected by default on mobile devices. This allows you to place a line with a single tap. Tap twice to place an X. Tap the X again to make the cell blank. Tap and hold for a while so you can draw a line. The Draw Continuous Line setting will help you reduce accidental moves when drawing longer lines. The Magnify setting is particularly useful when playing on a touchscreen. It will let you see what is going on under your finger. You can now solve puzzles like a pro.